Do you believe that the way we bid farewell to our bodies can affect our eternity? Dive with us into a surprising debate, cremation versus burial. Discover why your choice may not be as clear-cut as it seems and how it aligns with age-old beliefs. Get ready to challenge your convictions and uncover insights that could transform your view of life, death, and resurrection. Don't miss this revealing journey. Your perspective on the eternal is about to change. Did you know that recently, an increasing number of people have been opting for cremation over traditional burial? Experts point out that this trend is on the rise and could reach up to 70% of preferences in the next 10 years. Faced with this scenario, a relevant question arises: is cremation a viable option for Christians? Let's explore this topic in this video. In this gathering, I want to address and answer four fundamental questions. Firstly, what is cremation, really? Next, we'll investigate what the Bible mentions, if anything, about cremation. The third question, often raised, concerns the impact of cremation on the resurrected and glorious body that, according to Christian beliefs, will be granted by God during the rapture. And finally, if you are a Christian contemplating cremation, what aspects should be taken into consideration when deciding between cremation and traditional burial? Throughout this video, we will explore these questions in depth, providing a broader understanding so that you can make an informed choice aligned with your values and beliefs. So, let's start with the first question. What precisely is cremation? Cremation is a procedure in which the body is subjected to extremely high temperatures in a specially designated chamber, reducing it to its basic components. Most of the body, including soft tissues, is vaporized and consumed by heat, leaving only bone fragments. Subsequently, these residues are processed until they turn into a fine powder or ashes. The Bible mentions in Genesis, "By the sweat of your face you shall eat bread till you return to the ground, for out of it you were taken, for you are dust, and to dust you shall return." This passage alludes to the cycle of human life and our ultimate origin and destiny. Dust. In this sense, cremation can be seen as an accelerated return to this primordial state, since the body is quickly decomposed into the basic elements that constituted the human being before its existence. This process of transforming the body into ashes is meticulously monitored and involves considerations not only technical, but also reflections on the environmental and cultural implications of this practice. Throughout this segment, we will discuss how cremation aligns or diverges from traditions and beliefs, and how it fits into the biblical and theological context. According to information from the Crematorium Association, there has been a steady increase in the choice of cremation, a phenomenon that mirrors transformations in social preferences, economic limitations, and ecological concerns. Currently, more than half of Americans prefer cremation, a trend that is likely to intensify in the coming decades. From a scientific point of view, cremation is considered a more sustainable option compared to traditional burial. Studies show that conventional burials require extensive land areas and involve the use of chemicals for embalming, as well as wooden coffins and funeral monuments, resulting in a significant environmental impact. On the other hand, cremation, although it requires energy and results in carbon emissions, requires less space and resources, making it a practice aligned with the growing interest in more ecological solutions. In addition to ecological issues, the choice of cremation also reflects a transformation in cultural norms and religious convictions. This change in funeral traditions can be interpreted as an indication of the evolution of societies in how they deal with the concept of death and post-death practices, revealing a greater acceptance of cremation as an alternative method to traditional burial, not only for environmental reasons, but also for a reconfiguration of beliefs and values in the contemporary context. While some traditions see cremation as a form of purification and spiritual release, others turn to the Bible and sacred texts seeking guidance on this practice. Therefore, let's move to the second question. What indeed does the Bible mention, if anything, about cremation? It's interesting to note that in over 200 references to death in the Old Testament, burial is the predominant method of dealing with bodies. However, the Bible does not prescribe burial as the only acceptable means of caring for human remains. There are indeed accounts of bodies being burned, but these cases are not direct instructions on cremation as a practice. A notable example occurs with Saul and his sons. 1 Samuel 31:12. 13 recounts that after being defeated by the Philistines, their bodies were found by Israelites who decided to burn them. The biblical text states, "All the valiant men arose and went all night and took the body of Saul and the bodies of his sons from the wall of Beth-shan, and they came to Jabesh and burned them there. They took their bones and buried them under the tamarisk tree in Jabesh and fasted 7 days." This act was likely a response to the conditions of the bodies, which may have been mutilated or so deteriorated that they prevented a proper traditional burial. This passage illustrates an exceptional situation in which cremation was chosen for practical reasons rather than as a clear indication of preference or doctrine. Thus, the Bible does not provide a specific mandate on cremation, leaving room for interpretations and personal choices within the cultural and religious contexts in which individuals are situated. Another mention of bodies being burned, not directly referring to cremation, appears in 2 Kings chapter 21, where it is narrated that Manasseh sacrificed his own son in the fire, besides involving himself in condemned practices such as sorcery, divination, and consulting mediums and psychics. Moving on to 2 Kings 23:16 and 20, we find another situation. Josiah, in his reformist zeal, observes tombs near the mountain and orders the bones to be removed and burned on the altar of Bethel with the aim of desecrating the place. In verse 20, the text describes Josiah killing the priests of the pagan shrines and burning human bones on the altars to defile them. These passages illustrate that the burning of bodies or bones in these contexts had a ritual or symbolic purpose, particularly related to denouncing and purifying idolatrous practices or profaning places considered impure. In 2 Kings 23:16 and 20, Josiah's action marks a period of significant religious reforms in Judah, reflecting efforts to eradicate idolatry and restore worship to Yahweh. Thus, while the Bible mentions bodies being burned, such acts are contextualized in specific cultural or ritual practices, not presented as general recommendations or funeral practices for followers of the Judeo-Christian faith. These narratives highlight the diversity of funeral customs and symbolize acts of repudiation of practices considered abominable, rather than providing guidelines on cremation as we know it today. Josiah, driven by the purpose of purifying worship and reinstating strict adherence to the commandments of the Torah, embarked on an intense crusade against pagan shrines. The act of incinerating human bones on the altars in Bethel transcended a mere expression of religious repudiation. It represented a deliberate strategy to extinguish any remnants of rituals considered detestable. Although these actions do not directly relate to cremation as a funeral choice or autonomous ritual practice, they illustrate the use of human remains in religious contexts and the robust symbolism of fire in processes of purification and defilement. In academic circles, cremation has been the subject of investigation, addressing its efficiency and ecological repercussions. Experts in archaeology and anthropology have examined how different cultures throughout history dealt with their dead and the cremation methods they adopted. These studies reveal a range of customs ranging from open-air pyres to advanced cremation facilities designed to reduce the release of pollutants. From a biblical perspective, interaction with bones and mortal remains carries profound spiritual connotations. In Numbers 19:16, we find clear guidance. Touching the body of a dead person results in impurity for 7 days. This passage underscores the seriousness attributed to contact with the dead, reflecting the perception of death and the afterlife in the Jewish context, replete with symbolism and rituals emphasizing the sanctity of life and respect for the deceased. The verse in question highlights how death is perceived as an event that requires ritual, separation, and purification. Although cremation, as a way of treating human remains, is not explicitly addressed in the scriptures, it leaves room for interpretations and adjustments to Christian principles, considering the context and motivations. Interestingly, the modern perspective, supported by scientific studies, sheds light on aspects of cremation, particularly in terms of environmental impact. Comparative analyses between conventional burials and cremation indicate that the latter may be a more environmentally friendly option. This approach minimizes the ecological footprint related to the extensive use of land for graves and the release of methane during the decomposition of bodies, a greenhouse gas that intensifies global warming. Therefore, the discussion about cremation, intertwined with biblical considerations and scientific findings, goes beyond mere management of mortal remains. It addresses profound issues related to purity, memory, identity, and spiritual continuity, reflecting the complexities and challenges faced in contemporary times. The choice between cremation and traditional burial not only resonates in the physical aspect, but also echoes in spiritual and environmental dimensions, inviting conscious reflection on our values, beliefs, and the legacy we leave for the future. The exchange between faith and science remains an important vector in the evolution of funeral practices, reflecting the balance between reverence for traditions and the need to adapt to the new realities of the contemporary world. Moving on to the third question, we will address a recurring doubt. How does the choice between cremation and burial affect the promised resurrected body in Christian scriptures? This question is anchored in concerns about the integrity of the resurrected body in the context of the rapture. 1 Corinthians 15 offers an enlightening perspective on resurrection, elucidating that although our earthly bodies are sown in mortality and humiliation, they will be raised in glory and strength. They are buried as mortal bodies, but will rise as immortal spiritual entities. The passage highlights a fundamental transformation, the transition from a limited physical existence to a glorified and spiritual form. Therefore, in the Christian conception, the physical condition or state of the body at the time of death does not limit the divine power of transformation and resurrection. Whether through cremation or burial, the central teaching is that God has the ability to renew and completely transform, ensuring a glorified and eternal body beyond the constraints of earthly matter. This suggests that funeral decisions can be made considering personal and environmental values without compromising the promise of resurrection. This question indeed arises frequently and reflects a genuine concern. How can God gather my body if I choose cremation? First and foremost, it is worth remembering that God formed humans from the dust of the earth. Therefore, if God used dust to create us, He certainly has the power to reconstitute us from ashes. Let us also consider the various ways in which a body can be destroyed throughout history and circumstances. An individual may be devoured by wild animals, lose their life at sea, perish in battle, or even be consumed by fire. God, in His omnipotence, is not restricted by any of these conditions in terms of restoring or recreating our bodies. It is crucial to understand that regardless of the form of bodily disposal, all bodies eventually decompose and return to the earth or ashes, especially considering the time lapse after death. In essence, whether through natural decomposition or the cremation process, the end result is substantially the same. We return to basic elements. Therefore, the divine ability to resurrect us to eternal life is not limited by the physical condition in which our mortal remains are found. What is promised in the scriptures is a glorious transformation and recreation, a spiritual and immortal body that transcends material limitations and the circumstances of our passing. This promise upholds belief in God's omnipotence and the hope of resurrection, regardless of personal choices regarding funeral methods. If we delve into scientific knowledge about decomposition, we will observe that the breakdown of soft tissues can vary in duration, ranging from months to years until a body is completely reduced to a skeleton, a process known as skeletonization. Depending on environmental conditions, such as the type of soil where the coffin is deposited, it may take decades or even centuries for the skeleton to fully degrade into dust. Regardless of the interval after death, the conclusion is inevitable. Eventually, we all reduce to dust, except perhaps if resurrection occurs shortly after death. This reflection leads us to understand that divine omnipotence is not restricted by the condition or process of decomposition of our bodies. Taphonomy, the area of science that investigates how organisms decompose, fossilize, and are preserved after death, provides information on how elements such as temperature, humidity, and microorganisms influence decomposition. This field of study reaffirms how, over time, human bodies decompose, turning into simple components and eventually reintegrating into the earth. These scientific insights into bodily decomposition resonate with biblical perspectives on mortality and resurrection. While science explores the physical process through which all bodies pass, faith offers a vision of hope and renewal, ensuring that despite the transience of our physical state, there is the divine promise of a new, immortal, and glorified body, transcending earthly limitations and providing continuity to our existence beyond earthly life. In 1 Corinthians 15:42 to 44, Paul explores the transformation promised in resurrection, highlighting that the body, sown perishable, dishonorable, and weak, will be raised imperishable, glorious, and powerful, evolving from an earthly form to a spiritual one. This narrative reaffirms the Christian conviction that despite physical degradation and return to the earth, there is a continuity of existence that transcends the physical, promising an eternal spiritual life for the faithful. Moving on to the final inquiry of this video. How can I determine if cremation is the right choice for me? Here are some crucial reflections for those evaluating this decision or guiding others to consider it. Preferences for memorialization. How do you wish to be remembered? The choice may affect how loved ones will celebrate your memory. An urn offers mobility. While religious convictions, does your doctrine or spiritual tradition have specific guidelines regarding cremation? These guidelines may be decisive in your choice. Ecological concerns. Does your concern for environmental impact influence your preference for the mode of farewell? Some view cremation as more ecological, while others opt for green burials. Financial implications. The expenses related to cremation or burial are also considerable, influencing the choice according to the available budget. Heritage and memory. How do you want to be remembered, and what legacy do you wish to leave? This consideration can guide the decision, emphasizing the value and durability of your posthumous memory. When reflecting on these aspects, consider that the decision is extremely personal and should respect your values and desires, as well as consider the emotional comfort of your family members. The ideal choice is the one that resonates with your principles and the way you lived. Sometimes, a grave can be a source of comfort for family and friends, a physical location where they can feel a connection, remembering the loved one who has passed away. The body is there, even though the spirit has departed, and this tangible presence can offer comfort through memories. This possibility of returning to the final resting place and celebrating the memory does not present itself in the same way with cremation. Along the same lines of thought, ask yourself, do you prefer that, at the moment of farewell, your loved ones have the chance to see you in an open casket, providing a final glimpse, a more tangible farewell, and a celebration of your life and the impact you had on them? This choice can profoundly influence the grieving process. Another point to consider is the logistics for those who travel from afar to pay their last respects. A traditional funeral demands that acquaintances interrupt their activities to travel, often on short notice, to attend the tribute ceremony, as there is a time limit for the wake and burial due to decomposition. Although cremation is not explicitly mentioned or detailed in the Bible as a method for handling the body after death, the decision between cremation and burial should align with your values, beliefs, and desires. Considering also the impact on your loved ones and how they prefer to remember and honor you. Therefore, there is no explicit prohibition or specific endorsement of cremation in the scriptures. Biblical narratives of burial typically address burial, as demonstrated by the examples of Old Testament patriarchs such as Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, and Joseph, and even the burial of Jesus Christ in the New Testament. The absence of direct mentions of cremation in the scriptures opens up space for interpretations based on general Christian principles and church traditions. Some argue that given the body is considered a temple of the Holy Spirit, 1 Corinthians 6 19-20, it should be treated with reverence and dignity after death, which could tilt the balance in favor of burial. On the other hand, it is argued that since we all return to dust, as expressed in Genesis 3:19, for you are dust and to dust you shall return, cremation could be seen as an acceptable method to hasten this return, provided it is carried out with due respect. Historically, some branches of Christianity have shown resistance to cremation, anchored in the belief of bodily resurrection. There was a fear that cremation could somehow hinder this event. However, many denominations have reassessed their perspectives, recognizing that divine omnipotence is not limited to the material conditions of mortal remains. Ensuring that God has the power to resurrect an individual, regardless of the physical state of the body after death. The Catholic Church officially accepted cremation in 1963 on the condition that this choice does not reflect motivations contrary to the Christian faith in resurrection. Despite this acceptance, the Church still expresses a preference for burial of bodies or ashes, discouraging their scattering or non-consecrated storage. Therefore, the decision to opt for cremation often falls on personal judgment and individual beliefs, respecting the framework of the Christian faith. Many believers consider that if cremation is chosen with reverence and does not contradict the belief in resurrection, then it can be seen as acceptable. The biblical interpretation of funeral practices, including cremation, should be based more on general principles and fundamental beliefs of Christianity than on explicit commandments or specific references from Jesus Christ. In the Gospels, there are no records of Jesus specifically mentioning cremation or burial. His teachings emphasize salvation, the kingdom of God, faith, love, and repentance. The Christian emphasis lies in the respect for the body as a divine creation and a temple of the Holy Spirit, as stated in 1 Corinthians 6:19-20, and in the belief in resurrection. The resurrection of Christ is central to the Christian faith, symbolizing hope and the assurance of future resurrection for believers. The burial of Jesus, as described in Luke 23:50-56 and John 19:38-42, reflects the funeral practice of his time and culture, but it is not necessarily a directive for all times and cultures. Within the biblical and Christian context, what is important is that funeral practices respect the dignity of the body and are aligned with the core beliefs of the faith. The essence lies in the dignity with which we treat the body after death and how it aligns with the Christian hope in resurrection. If the choice for cremation is made with reverence and honor and does not contradict the belief in resurrection, then it can be considered an appropriate alternative for Christians. The focus should be on the spiritual meaning of death and resurrection, rather than on the method by which the body is disposed of. Additionally, it is crucial to take into account the traditions, teachings, and regulations of the specific denomination or faith community, as different groups may have distinct interpretations on the subject. In summary, the alignment of cremation or burial practices with the Bible does not stem from explicit instructions from Jesus or detailed commands, but from the respectful and dignified manner in which these rites are conducted, honoring Christian principles of respect for the body and faith in resurrection. I hope that the answers to these four questions provide clarity, especially if you are contemplating what preparations you desire for your own end. Although death is not an easy topic to confront, it is prudent to ponder our preferences for the future. May these reflections guide you in your decisions, providing peace and wisdom. Have you reflected on eternity today? This video was just the beginning. For more insights and discussions that touch the heart and soul, be sure to subscribe to the channel, like this video, and share it with those seeking answers. We want to hear your opinion in the comments. How do you plan to honor your journey to the end? God bless you.